Sometime back, I was driving with a car full of kids on a snowy road. When that happens, I try to keep a proper interval between my vehicle and the one in front of me. But evidently, this particular point, what happened, happened anyway, even with the proper interval. The car in front of me went out of control and began to skid every which way, stopping and then starting to skid again. And by the time it almost was through with these maneuvers, I had hit it. Has that ever happened to you? Not just like that, but some point of emergency or trauma where you've had to call on the reserve and the adrenaline starts to pour. May I introduce the program Night Sounds? I'm Bill Pearce, and each night that we are together in this fashion, we call on a new subject, something that's happened in our lives, something that may have happened to someone else, or an existing condition or situation, sometimes that we have no control over. Tonight's program I've merely called Emergency. Looking through a very valuable book, not so much monetarily, but as far as input and counsel, is one by a physician, Dr. Paul Brand, entitled In His Image. And he teamed up with one of the finest writers in the land, Philip Yancey, talking about the equation between the human body and spiritual verities. Well, he was in a situation similar to the one I just told you about. And he said, when I first learned to drive, my brain sorted out the sequence of nerve firings required for me to lift my foot, slide it to the left, turn the steering wheel with short, jerky motions in the direction of the skid. And unlike a novice, I didn't have to think, where is the brake pedal? In a moment of emergency and stress, my brain relied on a memory bank of programmed responses and sent high-speed orders along nerve pathways. The orders were, so to speak, foot-specific and wrist-specific. The brakes, the steering wheel. But the other complex reactions, the heart rate, skin changes, respiratory adjustments, all occurred because of this hormonal system. My brain initiated an order to a gland, in this case, the adrenal, to secrete a chemical messenger into the bloodstream. The hormone doesn't deliver a message as immediate, precise, and definite as the nerves, but in a few seconds, it can reach every cell in my body. Tonight's program entitled Emergency. Fear, relief, heightened awareness. Dr. Brand said, I felt all these sensations, and for the next 20 miles, they made me a much better driver. All my muscles, not just my foot and wrists, were poised for action. I saw better. I concentrated more on the hazardous driving conditions. These two types of communication, the nervous and hormonal systems, have a parallel in the spiritual body also. And as we come on the air with Night Sounds, night by night, each of our topics, subject matter, whatever direction we're coming from in our thinking, are based on a theological premise, because God is foremost and should be in our lives. He created us. Otherwise, we wouldn't be with each other at this point. Nothing would have happened that happened. God is the first and last cause. And he said in the Old Testament, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Back to driving, back to responses, back to emergency. Dr. Paul Brand said, At times, we may have a direct hotline from the head, a clear directive for a specific action. In my experience, those times occur infrequently. More commonly, I sense a certain prompting to respond, a heightened awareness or a pang of conscience about some command of Christ's that I have failed to follow. Christian literature has devoted so much attention recently to the gifts of the Spirit. And he asked, could such gifts follow alternate types of communication systems within the body? The Bible says some are chosen to be pastors and teachers and prophets and administrators. By ability and by calling, these represent a sort of central nervous system, a direct line of communication from the brain. And we cells rely on them to teach and interpret and to direct us in our various functions within the body. But, in addition, the Holy Spirit moves as a go-between force among all cells, gently bringing to mind the will of the brain, the head, and then permeating and mobilizing the entire body. Until recently, those in this field believed that glands such as the adrenal and pituitary sent out their hormonal instructions independently. However, new discoveries point to reliance on the brain at virtually every point. Instructions on growth, development of resources, on how to meet a crisis, these all originate in the head to meet the needs of the entire body. The glands and enzymes all act as agents for the will of the head, carrying the message to each independent cell. So it is in the spiritual body. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 15, and carrying into 16, reads, "We will in all things grow up into him who is the head, that is Christ. From him, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love, as each part does its work." So, that's basically what happens in an emergency, in a red alert. An interesting thing happened to me this morning. We were having inclement weather. There was a rain pattern just hanging over our area, creating all sorts of havoc for drivers, flood conditions, etc. I had the Weather Channel on just to see what was happening nationally and more specifically locally. And as I turned to do something else for a couple of seconds, I heard this little beeper going. It sounded like the beeper on the alarm clock or the radio. I'd never heard it before. It was coming out of the TV. Evidently, my television is programmed with a red strip along the bottom of whatever is on and a little alarm that sounds. And this red strip had an emergency message on it about possible flood conditions for our area. I thought that was pretty neat, but it alerted me to stay with the Weather Channel for a while until I found out the duration of this, where it was heading, and all of the necessary information. Tonight's program entitled Emergency. Maybe you're enduring or experiencing a spiritual, emotional, physical emergency or red alert now. Maybe it's been coming on gradually, so that in a sense you're not particularly looking forward to it, but you anticipate it. In other words, you're geared to some extent. But these sudden emergencies, the 911 kinds, put us in a state, as we've been explaining tonight, physically and even spiritually. Night Sounds is a total experience as far as I'm concerned, because it doesn't begin when I turn the mic on. It really begins when I arise in the morning, and even before that, when I awaken. My first words are, "Thank you, Lord, for whatever hours of rest you gave and allowed. I commit this day to you. Thank you for your mercies, which are new every morning." Sometimes that prayer sort of comes in pieces because I'm not quite awake yet. But this is when the communication starts. This program has no script. However, we quote a lot of people and give personal observations for what they are worth. Plus, I try to select music that speaks to and with and through the subject we're dealing with night by night. So, at this point, I'm going to enter into the musical agenda for a few moments. A song of prayer, as directed to the Lord by Twyla Paris, with a message in prayer, "Father, we are here." And whether she's speaking of an emergency situation or what should transpire every moment to open our hearts, minds, emotions, body, cells, the whole picture to the God who not only created us, but loves us intensely. Soloist Twyla Paris, song of prayer, "Father, we are here." Which reminds me that sometimes we pray as if God would be surprised at what we're telling him. And also, there are moments when we worry about something and try to fix it all up and take care of whatever's going on, feeling that we've got to do it, or it'll fall apart again. As if God didn't exist. I've done that so many times. Don't think of prayer till something happens beyond me, and I think, oh, man. In the event that any of you have joined us in the past few moments, you're in tune with a program entitled Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce, and what a joy it is, night by night, to come where you are, that we gather together in this manner. Through an old medium, radio, like an old friend, a lot of folk felt that when television arrived, radio would get on the tubes. But it's stronger than ever, and even better than TV in many instances. You don't have to look like anything, that's for sure. Neither do I, and maybe we don't, which is just as good. We will be going off the air in a few moments, and as we do, I just want to remind you once again that Night Sounds continues through compact discs, the treasury of recorded sacred music, the printed page, and certainly through prayer. That's the secret. That's the existent force of our God, through the Spirit, keeping us moving, upholding each other. If we can remember your prayer concern, please allow us this privilege. If you'd like a catalog on the various outreaches of this ministry, our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. And again, since each program bears its own title and direction, tonight's, we've used one word, emergency. In prayer, Joy Morgan Davis wrote, "What is it in the small hours of the night, Lord, that intrigues the mind and touches the imagination? Is it the darkness, where we walk with mystery and romance, or the stillness, where nothing stirs, or the solitude as soul and mind and body, when not bombarded by the noise and nuances of life, seem to blend into a clearer state of consciousness? What is it in the night that lets us leave ourselves for flights of fancy above our earth-bound being? Could it be because in darkness we are closer to creation, closer to our own inherent creativity? Once, when there was nothing anywhere but darkness, when all the world was without form and void, your imagination made miracles. The sun, the moon, the lion, the lamb, the mountains and rivers and Adam and Eve. Your vision of tomorrow turned night into day. If I am made in your image, Lord, I'm sure to have some of your imagination, some of the creativity that turned ordinary atmosphere into a paradise. I must remember that tomorrow, Lord, as I make my day." Tonight's program, Emergency, finds us quoting Dr. Paul Brand, a physician, Christian doctor, who has given some very valuable and penetrating insights into the equation between a body and spiritual movement. And he said even the most common acts that we get into day by day rely on elaborate confederacies, the monitors that measure oxygen intake and regulate breathing. Oxygen requirements also trigger changes in the heart rate and the chain of cells serving as the pacemakers of my heart, which is far better attuned to the needs of the body than any electronic wizardry inserted to replace it. The natural pacemaker listens to instructions from the vagus nerve, factors in readings of oxygen requirements. It also takes note of any special conditions that might call for increased heartbeat, as indicated by the presence of adrenaline. We can see evidence of homeostasis on vivid display in modern hospitals, where constant digital readouts report a patient's pulse and other vital functions. All cells communicate other needs. From the viewpoint of the body, taste, and appetite, they're mere techniques to compel us to provide nourishment. So let's listen to our bodies. The other day, I was looking through the phone book to see the various specialties of physicians. And out of page after page after page of doctors and healers, I saw only one who engaged in the specialty of preventive medicine. This is the best. If we can stay out of trouble through sensible living and patterns of habits and so on, listening to our bodies, we're much better off. And tonight's program, titled Emergency, reminds us of all of these things. Listening first of all to God, checking in on our body, exercising, engaging in sensible and good nutrition, various things we can do to help ourselves. And again, it's a much better scene than to call on the doctor after we're in trouble. Some, of course, are not caused by any of our lifestyles. They come to us through genetics or other means. But let's just, right now, call on our Lord to guide and to direct as He would. I'd like to ask Phil Driscoll now to sing a song in closing that goes right along with our thought processes tonight. God is there, and He will be there with us forever.
Be there. I'm your Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Whoa, be there when you need someone to guide you, to always stand beside you. I'll be your morning star, like a shining light through the darkest night. Just look for me. I can make it all brand new. Just call my name, and I'll be standing somewhere listening, waiting for the moment. Like so many times before, here I am again, door. Just look for me and I'll be there.
Mm-hmm. If your heart is feeling broken, I'll make it all brand new. Just call my name. I'll be standing somewhere listening, waiting for the moment, like so many times. And here I am again, knocking at your door. Just look for me. I'll be there.
Thank you, Lord, that you are everywhere. Right now, and you're with my friend listening, you're with me. We need you, Lord. Take us through the night and into tomorrow in your care. We love you. We give ourselves to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. If we can pray for you, be a friend, we want to do this. Let's completely yield ourselves to the great physician, who has the right diagnosis every time. We don't need a second opinion. And I'm so grateful to you for being right there where you are tonight. Let's do it again, okay? In God's divine providence, may He give you strength spiritually, emotionally, physically tomorrow to do His will. Until we meet again, a peaceful, restful good night.